Okay, guys, we're definitely marking fish, kind of like we were yesterday last time. Just all kinds of fish here. Little dots and blips. A lot of you may not be able to see it. I know you can't see it, but I can. And what we're gonna start doing is we're gonna basically start our chum in this area of fishing while we're moving upstream, and we'll drift back down through it. Now, you've seen my channel Cat Chum. I used to have a blue one, right? I have no idea what happened to it. I think it blew off the truck or something, so I had to kind of basically buy one from myself to use it. So this is the new channel Cat Chummer. It's basically a dog ball throwing device that I'm repurposing. I found a manufacturer in China who makes these things and produces these things, and I just bought a shipment from them, and we're gonna get out here and start chumming. So we got a half bucket of chum here. We're not gonna have to throw very far, but we're gonna just start chumming like that. Get some, probably do some zigzag here. The thing I like about the channel Cat Chummer is I can, you know, just I'm working the motor with one hand and I'm chumming with the other hand, right? And we're just gonna chum here. We're just gonna chum, man, because we're marking a lot of fish. And as you know, with my chum, there are black soldier fly maggots in there as well. Chumming is a common thing. If you look overseas, Britain, coarse fishing, float fishing, match fishing, feeder type fishing, chum is just everyday run of the mill. Now, a lot of times they'll chum with actual maggots, which works, and I have some maggots in here, but I think it's more economical and easier to just make you a plant-based chum here. Now, don't have to worry about it. The seeds are dead because they've been soured in yeast. But we're chumming an area of about a half a mile from the, where you see those rocks end over there, down here to one of the barge stations. And that's the area we're going to fish. We're going to chum here. And what we can do is, as we're chumming, we can take our device here and mark. We're noticing more fish a little bit further back up. But there's plenty here too. So we'll mark there, waypoint number 33. We'll just chum here, just chum. Just get some scent off into the water. Get some of the, they're back mostly over this way. We'll do some like that as well. We're not trying to make long chumming distances right now. That's really good like that. And we're only chumming small amounts. Just like that much is plenty. You could dump it offside of the boat like that if you wanted, but you want to spread it out. Now, we can get a whole heap of chum like that, mounding heapfuls, but it's just not necessary. The only thing we're trying to do is to get the fish into a feeding mood, the ones that are in the area, because we're gonna be drifting this entire half a mile. It's probably maybe a quarter of a mile, half a mile, somewhere there is between 3/8 of a mile. We may throw some off of one side of the boat, you know, like that, and throw some off the other side of the boat, and this is what we're doing. We're chumming up this whole area, and we're gonna be drifting this whole area. And so what we'll do is chum up this side for right now, and come back, and we'll move toward the middle of the channel, move back up, chum that on our way back up, and then drift back down, and then we'll go to the other side of the river, sort of the same distance from the bank we are now, chum that, and yeah, when you're chumming like this, let the wind carry it. That's the key. Sidearm it as well. You want to sidearm chum. Sidearm it. If you chum it like that, it's gonna, look at the direction, it's straight down toward the ground. So you want to sidearm it. Sidearm it and let the wind scatter and spread it out like a shotgun. That's what you want to do. That's the method. Get on YouTube and look up match fishing or float fishing, course fishing, bream fishing that the Brits do, the British do. Most of the time they're sitting from the bank, but this river is easily 5 times as wide as many of the rivers. What they call a river is what we call a creek around here, because all our rivers have been dammed up to produce massive traffic for barges, things like that. So you need a boat. I don't care what anybody says. If you're in America, especially in the Southeast, and all you have are these big dammed up rivers, you need a boat. You need something. I mean, I've been through it. I've tried fishing from the bank. You just can't hardly fish. Because it's so inaccessible. I mean, are you going to hike through 5 miles of wilderness just to fish that one spot and the fish are over there? That makes no sense. Get you a boat. You can get you a kayak, a canoe. I'm a humble guy, or at least I guess you don't call yourself humble if you're humble, right? But simple means, that's what I'm trying to say. Simple means, all I have is a 12-foot John boat. I make a lot of my own gear, as many of you know, and a lot of that gear is what you guys end up seeing me use, like this rod I made and this motor I built and hot rodded and all those sorts of things. But we're just chumming. Got this all the way up, one side and the other, one side and the other. And so, I'm just chumming like that. I'm just kind of steady chumming. So what we'll do is pull a drift on this chum. So let me get done with this. We got probably another few yards to go. Again, we're not going monstrous throws like that. There's just not really much of a need for it in this particular application. But, be careful, this stuff does stink. If you got one of those big fancy boats, you're gonna stink up your boat. You don't wanna stink up your boat. See, now that's how you do it. It's a sidearm upward, bam, right? Because if you try to go overhead, it's gonna just dump it right in the water. It's sidearm slightly upward. That's how you use the channel cat chummer. And so let's get done with this. I quit boring you, and we'll get on some fish, see what this daggum reel can do, and then I'll see you guys in a few. The good thing about soured wheat chum is that it sinks. You may not be able to see that, but it's sinking. It's slowly sinking. That way it's good so it keeps out of other people's motors or anything like that. You don't have to worry about all that. Just, it sinks. And that's why you want to use it. But, I just had a bite there. Yeah. Oh, we got something. We got something kind of big here. What is this, my friends? You see that rod bent over like that, doubled over? Oh, wow. We got a catfish, I believe. Let's see what we have here. Fiberglass. Oh, yeah. Sure enough. Ha ha! Channel multi-species. Just when I said we were gonna just be catching mostly, guess what do we come up with? A nice eating-sized channel catfish. Guys, it doesn't get no better than this. Drop shot. I chummed up the area with the chum, and we're using the bait. That's what's working. We're going to keep on fishing. Every time I resign myself to all I'm going to catch is bream today, well, guess what? You end up hooking with a nice channel catfish like that on that nice 5-6 weight fly rod with this, open your mouth, dude. That's just four weight, that's 4 pound test monofilament, guys. 4 pound test. Okay, that's a nice eating, that'll make a nice sandwich there. A couple sandwiches, actually. And he's being tight-lipped. Now he's open. Oh, the hook was just in his mouth and he was wrapped around the line. You saw it had that rod doubled over, boy. The ultralight approach makes it so much more fun to fish. Get him in there like that. I got a towel, I believe. Bring your towel with you. See? Keep your hands dry, whatever. See, I'm catching more catfish and bass by bream fishing. And this is not bream fishing. This is a multi-species approach. I don't care what nobody says. So, and all we're doing is drifting these drop shot drifting these black soldier flies on 4 pound test line, like you've been seeing me do. Right? So, and we chummed up about a mile here, about mile, quarter mile. Need to fix this oar. See how it twists. Need to tighten up that bottom one. I'm just really, honestly, just too lazy to do it. Once you get on some fish, you don't want to stop fix stuff, right? I mean, it's like, dude, they're biting. I'm gonna fish. Screw the whatever needs fixing. And that's on a number 10, essentially what most fly fishermen would call a nymph hook. They would call that a straight-eyed nymph hook. Two X long, you know, probably. That's what they would call it. You see that, don't you? Catfish. I mean, I have spent my summer using cheese baits, trying to use, cheese baits, trying to use cut bait. And the only thing that seems to be catching these cats are these black soldier fly larvae chumming up the area with the channel cat chum, with the channel cat chummer, and just pulling a long drift. Instead of chumming a spot, I'll chum an area of river. And then we'll drop shot it. My favorite weight is the 3/8 ounce. Definitely gonna have to go and make me some more weights, but I got plenty of quarter ounces and 1/8 that we can make something work until we can do. But so I tell you what, let's get repositioned here. I love the Okuma ABF 20 B series bait feeder. It's working well, and the wind is starting to blow us back downstream, and I don't think they're pushing any current. No barge traffic, seems like. And so once if you get in too close, just like this, you just get back out. This would be easy if it had an electric trolling motor. I'm not gonna lie to you about that. But you know, that electric trolling motor would put a little bit too much weight in this little small boat that I want. In fact, I wanna build a John boat. Don't know when I may not be able to do that till 2016, 2017 or something, but I'd make this same boat design, except I would take out these seats, have the whole boat open hulled, and make it 16 foot long, maybe a tad bit narrower, maybe come in an inch or two on the sides, because this motor really likes a very narrow boat. And I would, instead of having the transom canted out, I'd cant it back in. And so the wind's blowing us back upstream again, so the wind is unpredictable. So we're really just fishing this little spot. We're letting the wind just sort of dictate what we're gonna do. And sometimes that's what you do, that's okay. I mean, we're catching them, what's the problem? And it also means that we're fishing this area thoroughly. So next time, we'll probably just pick, instead of a mile long, let's pick a quarter mile. And that's it. So let's get back on them. We'll get back with you. See ya. Oh, little guy. He'll eat. wild caught fish, you know, depending on where you catch them, you know, you don't want to catch fish out of dirty water or anything, but wild caught fish can be healthy for you. You know, of course, be mindful of the fish you're catching and the waters you're catching them in. But wild caught fish can be healthy for you. You know, doctor says I'm diabetic, so I need some exercise. And so getting out here on this river, rowing like this, that's good exercise, gets the blood sugar down. Wild caught fish, a good source of protein, those omega-3s that they want your heart to have. And it's just good for you. So, you know, that's why I fish. You know, I don't fish for sport, man. I fish for my health. You know, one of the big things I believe with Black Foyer Lures is to build a life-giving business. So getting on these oars and trolling and stuff, that's good exercise. Eating healthy fish, finding and or making or importing products that can really help you do all that. It's a big part of the vision, and that's why I do this. You know, for years and years and years, I've worked in a day job in a convenience store where, you know, you're selling beer to alcoholics. You're selling fatty, salty, greasy foods to gluttons, and you're selling cigarettes to nicotine addicts. And that's just, and it just seems like just wrong, you know? And so starting Black Warrior Lures, the primary reason was one, to get out of my day job, two, and I'm still working on that, right? But two, to actually have a business that gives life and doesn't take life. And it's something that's sorely needed in our day and age. And so that's why I'm doing Black Warrior Lures. And the camera here and all I'm doing here just helps me, you know, sort of capture the moment as you were. We're getting bites there. Let's see if we can cook it. Got a bite, but he didn't take it. Yeah, still getting, must be a little guy, or maybe just not feeding. Or maybe just tripped over a log or something. But anyway, we get another one. We'll let you know. What's that, guys? What do you call that? 4-pound test line, channel catfish, drop shot. I mean, we're not, you know. They're in here. Look at that damselfly. It seems like every time I go fishing, damselflies are probably the most beautiful fly of all time. You know, dragonflies are pretty cool, but the damsels are better. But hey, another, you know, channel catfish, guys. We're not anchored up at all. All we're doing is just staying in this area with the oars and letting the wind kind of blow us back upstream, and we're kind of rowing back down, and we're staying in this general area. I mean, we've not covered half the water that we chummed. We've covered maybe a quarter, maybe a third of the water that we've chummed, and this little spot here is producing very well. And so, I mean, it works, guys. It just works. So, we're gonna get back at them. We're gonna put three. Seems that when I put three on there, I'm getting more catfish. But I put two, it seems I get more bream. So, oh, there's one. So that's what we're doing. And these are everybody talks about small catfish like that wanting to use 5-aught hooks. I'm using essentially fly fishing hooks, and I'm catching them just fine. if I could only have one hook for the rest of my life, that number 10, that's going to be it. I can catch bass, bream, catfish. I can catch anything. I've even caught striped bass with a hook that size. Believe it or not, I've caught striped bass with a hook that size, tied off an olive minnow pattern, basically. And we're just going to get back out here. We're not anchored up, you know. All we're doing is just kind of rowing out and staying in the same rough position here. The wind's kind of swishing us back and forth, and we just kind of use the oars to our advantage. And we're just almost like an eye pilot. The difference is I'm, you know, why spend all that money on iPilot when I can just use the wind, the current, and the oars to do exactly the same thing? I don't understand. Yep, just had a bite there. Oh, no, it took it away from him. But anyway, we'll get back with you in a minute. I think I'm getting too antsy now. Yeah, it's just reel up. I think he robbed me. No, he didn't. He's still right there, huh? He just didn't hook himself. He just didn't get hooked, so. And again, in some parts of the world, a number 10 hook like that is considered, like, massive. I know that might be hard to believe, but it's actually considered massive. What do you call that, folks? Channel catfish. All summer I've been looking for these guys, finally finding them. So again, he's full of that chum. I can feel it. He's been eating that chum. And we're just the chum. And I bet you, if we would have just switch up and put some cheese bait down off in there, we'd catch them just as well. I'd be honest with you. I actually like cheese baits, and I've had some guys who've given me some cheese baits. I've just hardly had the time to do it, and every time I go fishing, I just grab a bucket full of chum and maggots, and that's what I end up catching, you know, catching them off of. And so, because I like the multi-species approach, I want to catch as many different kind of fish as I possibly can, because that's the way I was raised. It's fun, it's all get out. I just love doing it, but that's what we're doing. And we're eventually just, and so in the past hour, we've probably moved all of maybe 20 yards because the wind just kind of kept this, you know, zigzagging back and forth, you know. And, let's get some of that slime off the line. Slimiest fish in all of human existence, you think, right? Catfish. There's some slimy sons of guns. Yeah, well. There we go. Drop it right back down. It's deep and clear. So, that's what we're doing. All those times I've been jugging and all that, nothing, just nothing, right? It's like, well, so much for the jugs. Hung up the jugs, maybe use the jugs, maybe repurpose them as a marker buoy, so we can, you know, mark some spots or something and put a jug out there and we'll see that jug, especially if we paint it up a bright orange or something. Sort of getting us back downstream a bit. And we're gonna get right back on them. We got a lot of water to cover because of the chum that we've put out, but and again, all I gotta do is drop the rod, get the oars, and right back on them. All right. We'll just see what we got right here. I think we got another catfish. There we go, folks. Channel catfish. Ooh, and he's real bad tangled up. Happen. That's a defense mechanism. It's just so that death. Oh, he's foul hooked. He's foul hooked. Weird. All right, let's get control of our boat here. Boat control is important. And every boat is different. If you're fishing from a kayak, it's going to be different from a canoe, different from a rowboat, different from a powerboat. Different from a small power boat, different from a big power boat. This is what I'm finding is working best for me in terms of just boat control. When it comes to anchoring, oh, it's such a pain. I've got a bad back trying to lift up anchors and stuff. But rowing like this is actually healthy for my back because I have a bad back. It's actually healthy for me to row like this. Believe it or not, it's just the craziest thing ever, right? But it works, and it works pretty well. I'm telling you, every time we put three of these guys on here, we're catching catfish, and every time we put two, we catch bream. So we're going to stay with three and continue on the drift. Okay. So we got something. What's that, guys? What's that look like to you? Another channel. Fun times! Come on, dude. Don't go all this twisting and death. This guy got many freckles. Freckle cat. Freckle cat. Ooh. I think I'm gonna have to put on another hook. I think the hook broke off. Yeah, it sure did. Tell you what. Ooh. That's why I like the drop shot. I can just, you know, come back on here and gonna break off the, no, that's a weird thing, broke off that, yeah, if I ever import me some hooks, I'm definitely gonna have to get me something like a 3x strong hook or 3x extra thick strong hook if I keep hooking into channels, but still, I like that size hook better than anything else, to tell you the truth, and they're such a small hook, I mean, you can just buy them, a lot of them, you can get a lot of hook for your money, it's my main thing, but anyway, let's get back out over the main channel. Okay. And let's hook up, rebait, and get back on. What's that, guys? Oh, he has got me all kinds of tangled up. Oh, man, he's got me all kinds of tangled up. He's got me all kinds of tangled up, guys. Don't know if we can untangle that. See, they hit that death roll because that's their defense mechanism, and it's like, if you got that, that's why I don't understand these dudes that fish with like 8 rods out, man. It's like, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, I think it's effective to fish with as many rods as you, ooh, as you can. He stung me there. But the way these guys tangle up the lines, ooh. This is good eating size channel cats. This is what I was catching all last summer on the floats, but we're just totally changing. Now, a lot of guys look at, ain't nothing wrong with a catfish that size. There's nothing wrong with a catfish this size, folks. It'll eat. And it's, to me, the meat's real tasty. And you don't have all those, all the lead and mercury and stuff that's, you know, the contaminants in a fish this small just yet. They're still, so we're getting a little mess there. Let's see if we can untangle, oh, it untangled for me. Ha ha, drop shot, baby. Well, maybe I spoke too soon. Not too bad. Okay. Gonna have to get here back out over the main channel again. Deslime the line. Need some kind of line deslimer, man. Probably could just get some of my homemade soap that I use and probably deslime and probably be just fine. Deslime the line. Get back on them. Be right back. All right, guys. Got another one here. He hit it hard, but didn't kind of gave up. There's a little guy. He hit hard and gave out. And anyway, that's what's catching him. So, oh, come on, little man. Come on, little guy. And once again, it's right in the corner of the mouth, just like if it were a circle hook. All right, we are beginning to approach the end of this drift, and it's a really little guy there. Little guys like this are real, I consider this to be a panfish, right? It's a panfish, because it's, if you just cut off his head and skin him, you can put the whole thing in a pan. So, that's why I'm, one reason why I like using the light gear. So, and see, look at that. After we hit him, these two guys are still on the hook. So we can just push them back down, drop them right back down, and go catch another fish. I just need to de-slime the line. All right. And there we go. So, bam. And we'll get right back on them. I hit it like that, and then once again, we're getting too close to the bank. We'll just get back out here more over the middle of the channel. And the wind's really working for us now instead of against us like it was this morning or before lunch. Yeah, we really need to take the time and tighten up that boat there. All it takes is the bottom boat. And so again, just like you saw, you just get right back out here. And it's almost like back bouncing. I'm not purely dragging. As I feel it hitting the bottom, I'll lift it up and let it hit down again. And then as it starts to drag a little, I pick it up and let it hit back down again. So it's almost like back bouncing. As some catfish guys would call it, back bouncing. But, you know, to me, it's all to trolling, drifting, back bouncing. To me, it's all the same family of fishing methods that are, you're not casting, right? You know, it's not a casting-based approach. That's one of the reasons why I gave up the fly rod, because the fish are down there in the water, not up in the air while I'm doing all this fancy casting. Oh, took it away from him. But it, I mean, it's not that I'm knocking fly fishing. I love fly fishing. But the thing I love the most about fly fishing is the long, limber rod. That's what I love the most. And the ability to create your own lures and things. I'm gonna reel this guy up because he probably robbed me. No, you think they rob you, but then they don't. It's like, dude, that's good. But the fly rod is great. The fly casting, you know, I think it's a great thing. The thing I learned the most was that long limber rod has a lot more power than you think. And it makes fishing so fun. And to me, fly fishing is ultralight fishing by definition. But as you can see, I've taken the advantages of fly fishing and combining it with some of the advantages of what I'm doing here. But anyway, so what do you think? What do you think? Does this chumming approach work? We're coming back down at the head of those rocks there where we first started. Does the channel cat chummer work? And does the long limber fly rod work? And does the Okuma ABF-20B work? Seems to be working. I think the fish have moved a little bit further out than where I first chummed, to be honest with you. But I always chum an area before I fish it. I do that because it just works. And so there's that back bounce. As it's drifting, lift it up, and they fall right back down there on the bottom. I get a lot less hang-ups that way. If I just sit there and let it drag, it's going to hang up and lose tackle. As you guys have seen me do many times. So this is somewhat of a, and it's amazing, I just landed on top of a hump or something there. Big gust of wind coming. Damn, looks really small now. It was big a few hours ago. And you know, one of the times I heard about this method of fishing was from kayak fishermen. He said, if you want to catch fish, and it's back when I was in my old P-Road, which is essentially a swamp kayak. He says, paddle upstream for several many miles and drift all the way back down to the point where you came in. I said, man, that sounds like a good idea. But see, I'm not an athlete, you know. Although I need the exercise, I mean, oh, here we're, see? I mean, we're really hung up there. Yeah, we're probably gonna, yeah, we lost that one. But anyway, I think we're gonna just turn it on in today. We've done pretty well. I think we're just gonna go ahead and just call it a day now with that. And, we could keep going because we're almost back to the point there where we first started. And I consider that to be a good day. I like the ABF 20B. You've seen the fish it's caught. I like the channel cat chummer. It's working well. These are available on Amazon. I'll be shipping a big shipment of these out to Amazon. But there's a few still left on there of the old samples that I had ordered. They're all red in this shipment. The shipment is always, and so you can see it. Sometimes it just depends on, it's a company that makes a lot of plastic pet products and for pets and things. And so I guess they just had a lot of red pigment left. And that's what they made these with, is just to cut down on the costs, right? So, there we go. Let's take a look at the cooler here. And see what the catch is like. There we go. Bream and catfish. No bass, but... Bream and catfish. All panfish, good eating every single one of them. Fun catching every single one of them, especially on ultralight equipment like I'm running. So there you have it. That's another show. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned something. Hope you It'll benefit you. Next time, God willing, in Christ, I'll see you guys later. Bye.